Okay guys, well, here's my skinning table. It's right here. I got a light right above it. I got all my boards and stuff back there. Plus I've got a thing of nails for my beaver boards, a little jug of water for spraying down the board for doing my otters and stuff. I got some extra boards underneath there, weasel boards. I got a fisher board, which I've yet to fill, but hopefully I'm gonna get to put something on it this year. And then I got all my different kind of knives in the holder there. I've also got a little trap that I put if I'm skinning like I did a weasel a while ago. So I just open that up, put his foot in it, and I have the ability to work right here, do all my rats on that too when I catch some. But anyway, so, and this is my fleshing beam. There's the beaver we just did up. So I'm gonna set him on here and show you how I made my fleshing beam. So basically it's just a big piece of maple, and I mounted it on a piece of channel iron and then welded it to a piece of tubing and then bolted it on there. It's nice and heavy. There's a spot I store my fleshing knives. And again, on this end, I've got all my muskrat stretchers, and I've got my muskrat board where I can measure them and that kind of stuff, put them on the board. Anyway, so what I'm going to do, this comes out like this, and it stores on the back of this table, right there, like that. And then what happens is I'm going to have to set this beaver for over here. Just set it down for now. Some of my trapping gear. This back section comes out. And this top comes off, and I'll show you when I get it off. It basically just lifts off like that, and I'll show you when it's off because it's pretty heavy. All right, so that's how the top comes off, and that's what it looks like when the top is off. I know you can see all the stuff underneath there, but what it does is now I take that beaver board and it fits right in the top, and I'll show you how that works. So that's how my beaver board fits in there, fits in down flush. Basically there's a design for this table in one of the trapping books, and I decided to improvise a little bit and make it all one unit. Plus it's on casters, so I can roll it around the room if I want to. Now we're just going to take our beaver skin and we're going to get them on the board. But let me get the camera set up with the tripod and show you how we're going to do this one. All right, so here we go. We got our board and our table. This is a beaver pattern that I got from the fur harvesters. It's a standard pattern. So what I want to do, I want to stretch my beaver out. And when I say the word stretch, I don't mean stretch it. I just mean open it up, give it a little tautness, just the right amount, so it dries appropriately, so we don't screw our grade up. We can screw our grade up by stretching these things too tight. And you know, these rings, I use these rings as guidelines. The beaver is the size it is. You're not going to make it bigger. You can make it smaller if you want, but that's no good either. So you know, just bring it out to where it to the size of the beaver. Don't try to stretch you know, a medium into a large, and you're going to downgrade your you're going to diminish your grade for sure. So what I use to nail the beaver on the board, I use 3-inch finishing nails, and I got a hammer here. I know some guys use different kinds of nails. Like I said, this is just what I use. So what I'm going to do first, initially, I have my eyes of the beaver here, and what I want to do is I'm going to start my first nail just above the nose, because you want to leave the eyes and the ears on the beaver. You don't want to put your nails back here. So I'm just going to roughly lay him out here. You know, he's just fitting, or you know, into that small section, that small ring. So I'm thinking that I'll probably be able to get out to the next ring. Now what I've done as well, I've found that once I start putting nails in, if it's still too loose, I'll even bring the nails out a little bit more. But you don't want this singing tight, because when that when the beavers do dry, they're going to shrink up a bit like that. The first one I put on a board, it actually bent the nails in. I put it too tight, so I learned my lesson there. So I'm just bringing this out. So when I decided Okay, so I'm on this ring. I'm going to probably go to the next ring, at least try to go to the next ring. So what I'll do is I'm going to take my first nail, like I said, just above the nose a little bit because I won't leave it, and I will put it in the center on that ring. Okay, I'm going to take my other one, coming down here, trying to keep my everything centered nice. I don't want to all twisted and all that kind of stuff. So here's the first ring, here's the second ring. So right about here, and I'm going to bring that beaver right over there. Okay. I'm going to start on this side. Here's the first ring, there's my second ring. I even got lines in here, so I know where the centers are. Bring that to here. I'm going to put the nails in really, really tight because you're going to have to take them back out again. We're going to take the beaver off the board, and it's a lot easier to take them out when they're not in there really far. So again, just grabbing the edge. There's my first ring, and here's my second. Just going to take the edge, going to come up to that second ring. Okay, now I'm going to start offsetting that. Start in front of my front leg here. Probably just in line, a little bit behind the ears, maybe like that, and dragging it up to that ring there. Again, the second ring. I'm going to come down to the bottom section. Here's the two back legs right here. I got a leg here and I got a leg here. Another somewhere down in here. It's that second ring. You know, I've gone to half rings. Just like I said, the beaver is the size that it is. You can't change that. So you might think I'm pulling that tight, but there's still a lot, it's still pretty loose there. Put that here. I'm moving. Here's the ring I'm going on. Right. I think we're pretty good there. So I'm going to continue to stretch this, and I'll show you what we're going to do when we're all done. We'll get to the legs. So you guys might notice I used a lot of nails.
when I was out in North Bay at the convention, Dave mentioned about when they measure the size and if they're scalloped, how it's going to reduce your size. You want to use lots of nails. Nails are cheap, whatever. I know it takes a little bit of time to get them in there, but you know, it's going to matter at the end of the day when it comes down to sizing and things like that. Plus, it's going to make a nice finish. You're going to see how when I was doing it, I was pulling this stuff out. This is what I was mentioning I was going to trim off after on the tail. Plus, on the nose section here is the other section I got to trim off, and I'll bring the camera in and show you what I'm going to do for that one. All right, so here we go. Here's the nose. Here's his two eyes. There's his ears. Like I said, here's his front legs. So, but what we have here, like I said, when I was fleshing him and I brought all that stuff on his face forward, that's where I was bringing it to. So what I normally do first is I just split this open, just like that, and then that frees things up to move out here freely. And then I just pull this taut and I trim it on the outside of the nails, just like this. There, just like that. And that gives me my nice round edge. And now we're gonna go do it on the back side too. Alright, so here's the back side. Here's the two ends of the tail. So this is where I cut around the beaver's tail. So here I'm going to trim this edge off here. I'm tugging on it a little bit, but I don't want to really pull on it hard, you know what I mean? There we go. Trim this little piece of gristle off here. Alright. Like I said, guys, I am doing this for the sale of the fur. I'm not doing this for a competition or anything. I know that there's a lot nicer ways to do up a pelt because I've seen it myself. So, but anyway, now I'm going to show you how I do up the leg holes, clean them up a little bit and stuff, and then I'll show you we're going to lift it up off the nails, and then she's good to go to dry. Alright, so now I'm going to do up the legs. Like I said, a lot of guys sew these up. Here are the hind legs, but what I normally do is I'll just trim the edge to get that. There's a little piece of gristle that generally gets left on there. So just trim that off, and it gives that leg a nice clean edge. And it gets rid of all the fat, so there's no no rot or anything like that there. You don't want any of that fat. So there's one. Take that little edge off there. One. Trim this off. You know, just take your time, be careful. You don't want to get real crazy doing this. Start spiraling around and then you end up with a leg hole about this big. You just want to take that top lip off if you've left anything on there. Maybe if you've cleaned it good enough, you don't have to do that section, but I generally do that. So there, I've got two open legs. And what I'm going to do, like you can see, I left a little bit of fat on that. I don't know if you can see it on the camera. So I'm just going to grab that leg, pick it up, get that one off. Cut that one off. A little bit of fat here. Clean up any kind of residual fat that might be left. Like I said, you don't want greasy pelts either, so you want to make sure you get all this stuff off of there. Just trim it off with a knife like this. Sorry if you can't see exactly what I'm doing here on the camera, guys. I apologize. Anybody that's taped themselves trying to do something realizes how hard it is sometimes. Well, all right, so I've got them all trimmed up. Now I'm going to nail the leg hold shut. So for the back ones, here's how I do it. I just grab it in the middle, and I literally just bring it out to meet. Some guys put it over and we'll nail it, just use that one nail. But I will put... So I'm grabbing the inside, still bringing it out to that. There. And then I take two on the inside, Just
find it doesn't overlap it. Don't know if it makes a difference or not. I'm going to do these ones, front legs, again, on the middle. I don't use the same amount. I usually just put three in the front, two from the inside, and one from the other. Close the hole. Again, some guys just put one, they flip it over and grab the other side. I don't know. This is just what I do, guys. So now what I want to do, I got all my nails in, everything's good. I don't want to leave my fur right on against the board here. So what I'm going to do is I got a screwdriver here, it's a Phillips, not that it matters, and I'm just going to put it in between, and I'm going to lift my whole fur up off the board. When I get to the legs, I usually get it from one side, and you can reach in and grab it from the other. Just pull it up nice. And then I'll push them down just to kind of get rid of the fur, just so they look nice. Keep pulling it all the way up. You guys can see what's happening here. I'm lifting it up off the board. So that's going to promote ventilation around the whole skin. Back leg. Push it back down through. There we go. As you can see, it's not really crazy tight. So, like I said, when I said I was stretching it, it's still good and loose. All the edges are up, but the middle's still sagging in the middle there, so it's still got a good roll. And that's pretty much it, guys. What I'm going to do when I put this, I'm going to put the fan on the side, I'm going to flip it up, and I'm going to put the head down, so hopefully that causes the fur to, they say it makes a difference when it comes to your grade. So, I'll turn the camera back on in, I don't know, 4 or 5 days, a week, whenever it's dry, and we'll take it off the board. Well, it's been about 6 days since we put that beaver on the board. And I'm out in the fur shed. I'm doing up some more beavers, and I thought I'd show you what it looked like before I pulled the nails, and I'll show you the finished product. We're going to take it off, we're going to back brush it all nice, and I'll show you what it looks like when it's done. But this is what it looks like now that it's dry. So as you can see, it's nice and hard. That's how it turned out on the board. Of course, this is where the trap got them. So we're going to get all those nails out, and I will show you the finished product. This is the finished beaver pelt. It's all dry. It's not tanned. This won't last. If you want to use this for garments or something, it would have to be tanned. So when we sell them at the auction, generally the purchaser will send it off to their tannery. But the one thing I want to do before I consider it finished, I'm going to give it a real good brushing out. Okay, just going to brush it all out really nice here. Trying to get everything out. Back brushing it as well. Give it one last little shake. And there we go. This is the finished product, and this is how I send my furs to the auction. This is how I put up my furs, and I appreciate you watching.